and I'll always be begging for a piece of me to stay. Maybe some things never change.
Hello and welcome to my room tour at the University of Washington. I stayed in a cluster setup, so this is my entrance hall. This is going to be relatively unedited because when I was looking at room tours, I couldn't find any that were just a straight walkthrough. So as you walk in, this is my room. I shared it with one roommate. My bed cover was a quilt that my mum made from a bunch of different like t-shirts that I collected. Those are some photos from my friends. We used to cover band album covers. And then you've got a desk. It's a bit small, but it fits everything you had. Granted, we had a room that didn't have a window desk. Like, a lot of my other roommates had a full window desk, but there are definitely some better rooms than others. And then I had like my shelves. I had a letter from that my friends had written me, some Polaroids of my friends, some Christmas cards, a map of the US that I was ticking off with every state I visited, a bobblehead that I got from the gymnastics team, some pictures of my friends, and then I pretty much had a junk shelf, which just had like water bottles, and I had the most school spirit, so I had a lot of University of Washington random junk. And that was a calendar that my friends made for me, and there's some sperm posters which I will tell maybe later. And we also had a recycling and a normal bin. It is Seattle. The view was definitely the best thing about the entire room. We actually looked out onto a soccer field and a golf course, and you could see the Husky Stadium if you looked really, really far to the right. But right beneath us was actually the car park where people used to tailgate for football games. So for that entire Saturday or Sunday, whenever the football game was on, you would just hear music coming out, and it was always fun when your team won. It wasn't the greatest fun hearing the other team partying, but it was a nice atmosphere either way. And then at night there'd be like helicopters flying down, which I never actually managed to work out why they were flying there. I think it might be for the hospital, but I assume the hospital has their own helipads, so I'm not really sure. One time in the balcony, I actually saw a girl crying, and it was at night, and my roommate was asleep, and I went to open the window, and she was just sobbing on the phone, and I was about to go, "Oh, are you okay?" And she was on the phone to someone, and she said, "I just can't get any privacy around here," and she was crying because there was a lack of privacy. So I just decided not to let her know that, yeah, I was watching, because then that just, you know, furthers the privacy issue there. Well, this was great. We had cupboards that you could change into, which are nice because you can also keep stuff in there. Like, I kept a portable space heater because the dorm would just turn off the heating sometimes. Like, over Thanksgiving, they just assumed everyone went away. And I stayed with my family a lot over Thanksgiving, but we came back for a football game, and it was freezing that night. And then, like, it was so sporadic, like, the heater barely worked half the time. And you're not meant to have space heaters, but I just hit it in there and it was fine. But here is the heater, which doesn't work at all. You can't change the temperature, like, you're just stuck at whatever they put it at. And then once you leave, you're back in your cluster. And there's, like, the bathroom, which is shared between 8 of you. And it's got 2 sinks and a mirror. And then we have all these little cubbies which you can put your stuff in. I kept my towel there because we put up this curtain, which was a great idea because, as you can see, if you walk out the shower, you're just in the bathroom. So my roommates came up with this idea if we all pitched in and got a curtain. But the curtain would knock my towel off and it would end up on the ground, and I think that's disgusting because that ground had to be disgusting. So yeah, that was my little cubby there. You have the bathroom, you have a urinal as well, but it was a girl, all female cluster. I did pee in the urinal once because I was curious to see if I could pee in a urinal. At the moment, somebody was drying their clothes in the bathroom. Yeah, there's your toilet. Nobody ever changed the toilet paper. Like, oh, I don't know how. Well, how do you not know how to change the toilet paper? You're 18. Come on. So this was our little lounge. There's my posters that I put up after a game, and we used to have, like, a game guessing which one other people would find the most attractive. It was very objectifying, but fortunately we were doing to the men and women, so we weren't being sexist, we were objectifying everyone. And then my cluster was actually really cool, we all really got along. Only 2 of the girls didn't hang out with us, but the rest of us, the other 6 of us, got great. And they made this Christmas thing. And then they put these Christmas things up, and then these Christmas things, and then all these Christmas things, and then if you go to the balcony, they lock the balcony during exams. Our RA just did a really bad job at locking it, in terms of he came in to lock it, and then I don't know what happened, because I made a joke about, like, ramming through the door, and it actually opened, and I was like, oh, okay. But the reason they lock it is apparently because people commit suicide on exams. I don't think that that's true. If it is, that's super sad. They need to do more than just locking the balcony if students are really struggling that much. I think it's more so that you can't go outside and be yelling at night. Not that that was really a problem. I don't know why they locked the balcony. So we had a great view. I wish I kind of filmed this during the daytime, but I didn't. So tough. And that's Haggett Hall over there. That wasn't even being used because it cost more to actually run, like, the heating and all that than the students would pay to live there. And that is, I think, the cheapest dorm on campus. I'm not sure. And then, yeah, we had a pretty high up because we were on the 10th floor, but there was also, like, some basement areas. You could yell to people down there and say hi. I didn't, but you could. Yeah, you weren't allowed to keep anything on the balcony apart from, like, furniture that was meant for balconies. We put a tent up there to dry once, or my roommate did, and they told her off within, like, 40 minutes. She had someone at the door saying, yeah, you have to remove that or you're going to get cited. And that's the shops, and that was nice because they decorated it for Christmas, which was cool. There's one more floor above us, so on the 10th floor. It's not, like, the most eye-catching dorm, and it's pretty old, but Ted Bundy used to live there, so it kind of makes up for it. Yeah, there's asbestos in here, but they've managed to avoid the lawsuits by saying, just don't make dust. So as long as you don't make the dust, you should be fine. And if you do make dust, then that's your problem and you can't sue UW. But yeah, it's an experience. Like, I would definitely live in this dorm. I definitely wouldn't live in this dorm for more than a year. But it wasn't a bad dorm by any means. It had a lot of storage as well. Yeah, there's a cupboard. That's a cupboard which looks like it's full of alcohol, but I swear there's food in there as well, somewhere. And yeah, then I had all my storage, like, all my shirts. The only annoying thing was that the bed kind of hung over the storage a bit too much, so it's a bit of a pain in the ass to actually try and get your clothes that are further back. And yeah, overall it's a really nice dorm. Like, it's nice to have a cluster. I think it may not be luxury, just making those friends I think is a bit more important than living in luxury. Like, there's only so much time in your life where you can live in, like, dorms and stuff, right? It gets a bit, if you're 45 and you're still living in a university dorm, it's a bit weird. So I'd make the most of it while you can. But anyway, that was my unedited walkthrough. I hope that was informative. If you have any questions, please feel free. If you want me to edit it and make it look nice, I do have other footage that I can use for that. What I was looking for with all my dorms is I just wanted a plain, like, simple walkthrough so I could gauge, like, the actual space without it being so edited that you can't really see what's where. And yeah, have a lovely week.